Greetings to all. And now the lecture which we are going, you are going to listen today is a continuation of special random process. This is a Markov process. In this lecture, you are going to get the input of Chapman-Kolmogorov theorem and its application in the random process. Chapman-Kolmogorov theorem, we consider the homogeneous Markov chain with the transition probability matrix capital M, which is equal to the probability elements Pij, small Pij, and the n step transition probability matrix is denoted as P, capital P, the whole raised to bracket n, which is nothing but a matrix where the elements are n step probabilities, small pij, the whole raised to bracket n, where the probability, n step probabilities, are defined as the conditional probability, capital P, given xn equal to j, subject to x naught equal to I. And Pij bracket 1 is the one step probability, and that is simply denoted as Pij. So here we are going to consider the n step probabilities, which is the conditional probability after n steps from state I to state j. That is why it is represented as Pij, whole raised to n, n meaning after n steps. So the properties which hold is, the first one is the m plus 1 transition probability matrix, that is the matrix formed after n plus 1 m steps. That is nothing but the product of m transition probability matrix and n transition probability matrix. The second property is the n step transition probability matrix is the same as the nth power of one step transition probability matrix. That is why we see in the second property, you can see P raised to bracket n, which denotes the n step transition probability matrix, which is equal to P raised to n, which is the nth power of one step transition matrix. Okay, you can identify the difference between the capital P, which has a bracket, and that which is without the bracket. Here in this, we are going to consider the homogeneous Markov process xn, n greater than equal to 0. You know all the meaning of a homogeneous Markov process, which is probability Pij at step n is the same as Pij m at step m, both the probabilities are the same, that is at step n and at step m. That is homogeneous Markov process. And what do you mean by Pij whole raised to n? There is the n step probability, which is nothing but the conditional probability of the random process at state j. This is at state I. N step probability, transition probability, is defined as the conditional probability of xn equal to state I, subject to the condition x not equal to I. So here, what is capital P? That is the TPM, transition probability matrix. It is simply Pij, probability elements. And what do you mean by capital P, the whole raised to n? That is the n step transition probability matrix. P raised to bracket n is nothing but the probability elements at state n. So these are the some important formulas which you should know for the application in problems. So with this in mind, we will discuss some problems. Say for example, we will consider the first the transition probability matrix of a Markov chain. Xn n greater than or equal to 0 has three states. The states are denoted as 1, 2, 3 with the TPM capital P given as and the initial probability distribution is given as P of small p of 0, that is given as 0.5, 0.3, 0.2. We have to find the following. Determine one will be find the probability at step 2 with state 2. The second one is find the probability of x3 equal to 3, x2 equal to 2, x1 equal to 1, x0 equal to 3. So the solution to this is here we are considering first, this is our transition probability matrix, initial probability distribution, and here this Markov process has got three states, that is 1, 2 and 3. So first question is find probability of x2 equal to 2 at step 2 with state 2. Before proceeding to the solution of the first problem, we will first analyze what the meaning of this initial probability is. Here we are given that P of 0 is equal to 0.5, 0.3, 0.2. You can see that the sum of these probabilities elements are 1, and we will elaborate on this probability, that is x0, initial state. So in this initial step, x0, when the state is 1, what is the value it takes? 0.5. Similarly, initially when state 2, the probability value is state 2. This is 0.3, similarly, and state 3, the value is 0.2. Next, we know by Chapman-Kolmogorov theorem says that P raised to, I want the two-step transition probability matrix, P raised to bracket 2. What is this value? By Chapman Kolmogorov theorem, the property, second property, we know this is the same as capital P squared. That is the second power of TPM. What is our TPM here? It is this. So this multiplied twice. This is P again P. So the value which you get, you can work out, and you can see that you will get the value of this form.0.39, 0.34, 0.48, 0.32, 0.39, 0.38. Here, this, these are all small piece probability elements. Okay, so from this, we have, now we will proceed to find out the first one. Probability when x2 equal to 2. So here, keeping this in mind, what about probability when x2 equal to 2? By definition, this is nothing but sigma probability x2 equal to, here we have, by the law of probability, so this is x naught equal to I into probability of x naught equal to I, summation over I. This is the formula for probability when x2 equal to 2 to calculate this. We will, okay. So here we have, I will rewrite what is the values once again. So we will get 0.27, 0.39, 0.34, 0.2, 0.48, 0.32, 0.23, 0.39. 0.38. So here, the first question, to answer the first question, probability when x2 equal to 2. This is sigma p x2 equal to 2 subject to the condition x0 equal to I into probability of x naught equal to I, where what are, what is I? The state. How many states are there? 1 to 3. So 1 to 3. So when we expand this, you will get probability x2 equal to 2 subject to the first one, state 1, plus probability x2 equal to 2 subject to state 2, plus the last state, so here we see that you, what is this, you, how do I read this? This is two-step probability from state 1 to 2. Okay, so this is nothing but P I J whole raised to 2. What is I? From 1 to 2. So state 1 to 2, and what is the step? It is 2. So this is nothing but second step probability, where the state varies from 1 to 2 into probability x naught equal to 1. What was the value at x naught equal to 1? Initial probability at state 1, it was 0.5. Plus the second one again. Here it is again the second step probability from state 0 to 2. Here it is 2 to 2 itself, therefore it is P22 whole raised to step 2. State is I to j, that is 2 to 2 into this, the initial probability at state 2. What was the initial probability at state 2? Here we have it as into 0.3 plus the last one. This is again two step probability from which state? 3 to 2. So it is P32 second step into initial probability at 3. What was the initial probability at 3? 0.2. Now, what are the values here? What is this value? In the second step, the second step transition probability matrix, you take the value P12. That is, P12 is 0.39 into 0.5 plus second transition probability matrix, the probability element is P22, that is 0.48 into 0.3 plus, and this again second transition probability matrix probability element is P32, that is third row second element. What is that? So ultimately, when you multiply this, you will get the value as 0.417. So this is the value for the solution for the first problem. The second question is to find the probability when x3 equal to 3, x2 equal to 2, x1 equal to 1, x0 equal to 3. So how to find this? Here first we will find out what is, find probability x1 equal to 1, x0 equal to 3. So what is this? This by conditional probability, by the law of conditional probability, it is probability x1 equal to 1 subject to x0 equal to 3 into P of x0 equal to 3. So here we will write what is capital P first, because it is the values of capital P will be applicable here. So I will write this matrix. You can see that the sum elements, row elements, total to 1. It's a Markov matrix. So you know that the sum of the row elements should be equal to 1. And here we will see that what are the values here. X again, this is the conditional probability from which is the state x1 equal to 1 subject to x0 equal to 3. So this value is nothing but Pij, that is 3, 1. This is first step into probability when at the initial probability of state 3. What was that? That also we will write here. What is P of 0? 0.5, 0.3 and 0.2. Therefore, this is the third one, that is into 0.2. Now, what is this probability element P31? The probability element at 3, 1, 3, third row, first column, 0.4. So, 0.4 into 0.2. What is that? 0, 0, 8. Not 2. Sorry. Here. Similarly, we will find the, so first we will start from finding what is probability. We started with probability of x1 equal to 1, x0 equal to 3. So we will name this as 1. Moving to find out what is the next step. Secondly, we will find probability of x2 equal to 2, x1 equal to 1, x0 equal to 3. Again, by the definition, by the law of probability, we know that it is nothing but probability of x2 equal to 2 subject to x1 equal to 1, x0 equal to 3 into probability x1 equal to 1, x0 equal to 3. Remember, we are using P of A given B. P of A intersection B by P of B. So here, again, this is nothing but P1, state 1 to, this, you know, this is a Markov process. So Markov process homogeneous, and by the Markovian property, this depends only on the previous state. So it is enough if I write it as x1 equal to 1. Just the previous state x1 into probability of this. What is the probability which we have already obtained here from equation 1? That you can straight away apply that, 0.08. Okay. So this is nothing but from state 1 to 2, that is element P12, what is that first row, second column, 0.3. Into, which is 3 equal to 3, x2 equal to 2, x1 equal to 1, x0 equal to 3 is again given by probability of x3 equal to 3 subject to x2 equal to 2, x1 equal to 1, x0 equal to 3 into probability of x2 equal to 2, x1 equal to 1, x0 equal to 3. Again by, since it's a Markovian process, we know that it depends only about the previous step. So x3 equal to 3 subject to x2 equal to 2 into, this value is given from equation 2, so I will straight away write that. And this is equal to, you know, this is from the probability element 2, 3. So what is P23? Second row, third column, 0.3. So 0.3. into 0.24. So in this case we have, so this value is nothing but 3, 2, 1 subject to the initial condition x0 equal to. So, next we will have, I will discuss another problem regarding the construction of a TPM, how a TPM actually, you can see practically what is the, how a TPM can be constructed with the given inputs. So here, we consider this as an example two. In example two, we are going to consider the framing of a TPM and see how the states are classified. Here the problem is, in the intersection of a working traffic light will be out of order the next day with probability is 0.07. And an out of order traffic light will be working the next day. It has probability 0.88. So with two, the constraint here, the Markov process is xn equal to 1. State is 1. When on day n, the traffic light will work. And xn is equal to 0. State is 0 when the traffic light will not work. So is this xn a Markov process? And if so, the TPM is given, is asked. So here, the traffic light working or not working depends upon the immediate previous state. So it is clearly a Markov chain. So yes, it is a Markov chain. Working condition of the traffic light depends upon the immediate previous state. So that is xn plus 1 depends on xn. So if so, then what is the TPM? So here there are two states. What are the two states? 0, 1. This denotes the non-functioning of the light. Whereas 1, the state 1 denotes functioning of the light. So first you write the states and then we will discuss what is this P. So here the P, TPM, transition probability matrix, can be read as the elements under the state 0, 0 means that is the light is not functioning. The next one is at 0, 1. What is the probability? That is first it is not functioning and the next day it is functioning. On the first day it is not functioning, the next day it is functioning. So in that case, we are given two probabilities, 0.07 and 0.88. So we will see where it fits. So in the next one, what is this probability element at 1, 0? What do you mean by 1, 0? State 1, 0. So first, 1 is the functioning of the light on day 1. The next day, it is 0, takes the state 0, which is non-functioning. So in that case, we have 1, 0. The first, it is functioning. Next day, it is not functioning. And what is this element? P11. The 11, P11 denotes both functioning on day 1 as well as day 2. So here we are given 0.07. That what is the probability it will be out of order the next day? So first day it was working. So what is that? Working is 1. So it is under 1, 0. You write this. It takes the probability is 0.07. Next, what is 0.88? Out of order traffic light will be working the next day. So it is first not working, then it is working. So it is 0, 1. So under 0, 1, the probability you write. What happens to the remaining elements? Since it is a Markov matrix, you know the row elements total to 1. So this can be, this is 0.12. And in this case, this element is 0.9. 9.3. So this is the TPM for this Markov chain. Next we will come to another example. So in example 3 we will just find out what is the initial probabilities. This is with respect to a message transmission system is found to be Markovian. With transition probability of current message to next message. As given by the matrix capital P equal to 0.2, 0.3, 0.5, it's a Markov matrix. Therefore, the row elements total to be 1. The initial probability states, that is P0. Is given as 0.4, 0.3, 0.3. Find the probabilities of the next message. Of the next message. So here we are given a message transmission system is found to be Markovian with transition probabilities of current message to the next message. It is given by this TPM. Initial probability states are given. There are 3 states and you can see state 1, probability 2 and 3. Find the probabilities of the next message. What is the probability of the next message? So in this case we have we are supposed to find out what is P of 1. So what is P of 1 here? By definition you know P of 1 is P of 0, initial probability, into the TPM. That is Pn is equal to Pn minus 1 into capital P. Understand the difference between small p and capital P? These are the probability elements. And this capital P is the transition probability matrix. So P1, I want the next message. What's the probability of the next message? You are already given the initial probabilities. That is, it is given by 0.4, 0.3, 0.3 into capital P, 0.2, 0.3, 0.5, 0.1, 0.2, 0.7, 0.6, 0.3, 0.1. So once you multiply this, you will get the value as 0.29, 0.27, 0.44. So this gives you the probabilities of the next. So you can now in this lecture, now we have discussed about the Kolmogorov result and its application in Markovian process. So here, moreover, also we have seen that in the practical application of a Markovian chain, how it is used and how we can determine the transition probability matrix with different states. In the next class, we will continue the stationary distribution of a Markovian chain, which involves again the eigenvalues and eigenvectors for the Markovian chain. Thank you.